Maybe pick some more active supports in the early game, because when you have two supports, you're relying a lot on being on point with your rotations and your cores doing a lot of work. And that's not easy to do when opposing team has five useful heroes and you kind of have three that are enabled by your other two
10 seconds
heroes.
remaining.
Maybe stay away from the Shaker and the Dazzle.
Five
Shaker
seconds
wasn't
remaining.
what he was an off lane, he still really do that much. He was more of a support towards the start of the game.
Yeah.
I can't remember who their other support was, actually.
They
The
had Dazzle
Lina.
Lina, and it just didn't seem
Yeah.
to be. I feel like the offlane Earthshaker, it's meant to get more farm and more experience than a support Earthshaker would. Getting you that blink, getting you that Echo Slam earlier, he did neither there, unfortunately, just having too much trouble with the Tusk Razor, and so very little game impact it felt like from Jenkins.
10 seconds
Either way, we
remaining.
have SF banned out. We've got Quap also knocked out, so apparently they did not enjoy Francis's Quap. And then Doom Slaughter. I think the Slaughter did quite a bit of work there after the after he got off to a bit of a rough early start. And of course Doom, everybody's favorite hero that wrecks your face. But we have a Dox here, which means we're gonna see some beautiful vacuums. I always enjoy that. And we have Wyvern in the pool, something that Leviathan loves to pick up, so they might just go for that staple.
10 seconds remaining.
You're not saying anything, PQ. Oh, you probably, you know what happened? You
Seconds
probably
remaining.
crashed or something. No? Hello? PQ?
Hello?
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 Radiant team.
Apparently,
Hear me?
PQ just can't hear me. I can hear you, PQ, now. Oh yeah, we have technical issues, guys. Quality production
Hello?
value. So, he apparently can't hear me, which is great. I'm gonna try to message him some. Either way, let's keep looking at this draft. They go with the Ember Spirit pickup again. It's really strong, but not fantastic.
10 seconds remaining.
Hello? I'm saying hello back.
5 seconds remaining.
Hello? I can hear you, PQ. I don't know why you're not speaking back to me.
Reserve time.
You are. Hello? Why do you keep saying hello then?
Yeah,
Talk about
because you're.
the draft.
Okay, fine. I think I said before where I expected them to play from 9 again because Darkseer Ember's pretty disgusting, and I'm not surprised they don't want to give it to Ritsu and they go for the Wyvern, which preferred hero. It was Leviathan that played the Wyvern, right?
Yeah, but I mean, a lot of teams love love Wyvern, but Team Leviathan has picked this hero up a bunch. So, and just so folks know, because I know you might be confused, this is Ritsu. This is Mason. He's standing in for Brax just today, and this is Francis. Everybody else is as their names say. So it is Leviathan who like the Wyvern, they get that, but now Cloud9 get the Dazzle Doxia, which is a nice way to deal with a Wyvern. You can just Shallow Grave whoever's been Winter's Cursed as long as you're out of it.
Yeah, I think Dazzle's just for a lot of teams at the moment.
Yeah, a super strong support. It feels like it saves your carry. It's strong in lane. A
5 seconds remaining.
little bit, I feel, of ganking potential. It's not great. So.
Reserve
I mean, if
time.
you put it with a Shadow Demon or some like a PL, you can do a lot of pressure with PL. Outside of that, it's just really defensive, I guess. Be surprised if they
Yeah,
pick a bit of a harder carry to pair with it this
radiant
game, though, as
team
opposed to
ban.
the Ember Spirit. Or at least something that can go in once it has a certain level of farm.
Yeah,
Philly Cinder
so
Ghost is a lot better.
they ban out the Windrunner. Cloud9, I guess, decided they're done with that. They don't want to give it over to Leviathan, and instead gonna be a Tusk. I always worry with an Ember Spirit. He takes such a long time to get online. Yeah, Leviathan have this Wyvern, which they're very comfortable with. They've picked it 14 times
Five
recently,
seconds
and
remaining.
50% win rate. It feels like. You need other
Radiant
heroes
team.
that are gonna make you a bunch of space just to get the Ember Spirit online.
Yeah, and the Cloud9 banning out AA, they have the option of banning the Alc'Kid for Leviathan,
10 seconds
or they could pick it
remaining.
up themselves, be a bit clunky with the Ember, so
Five
I hope they
seconds
don't.
remaining.
Could work, just hero's pretty strong.
Yeah,
I wouldn't
sorry,
be surprised
I'm.
if they have to ban it out.
Just having a bit of a giggle now that we've got the 2 minutes delay and everybody else is hearing our little hello, hello,
hello, hello.
It was, no, I have this issue where I didn't know whether TeamSpeak went down for a second there and I actually couldn't hear you for a bit and then you just kept saying hello and I was so confused.
Yeah, but either it was way. Like, I couldn't hear you say anything back and I was like constantly turning my mic yeah. and mute off and on. But I didn't hear you say, yes, I can hear you. I was like, hello, hello? Because I expect you to tell me you can hear me.
No, I was. I think we had a little bit of TeamSpeak died for a second there. Okay, is what okay. I'm going to blame TeamSpeak. I'm not going to blame either of us. We're going to pretend we have excellent brains. Either way, let's get into this. We got a nice AA ban out, Cloud9 not wanting to have to deal with that crap. But with AA banned out, Leviathan gets themselves a Huskar. And I was talking about needing more space to be made for your Ember Spirit. Huskar will do that. He can fight at like level 1 with Burning Spears.
Yeah, this is a hero you pull out when you need to win a game, I feel like. I think Leviathan are one of the teams that have always preferred playing Huskar since it became a thing. They should have an issue with the hero and know how to play around it. I think Cloud9 don't do what I used to do and panic here, and they just deal with it
I think
way or another, and they pick a decisive game plan. This is like the really important point of the draft. But you either pick to deal with the Huskar at a certain point of the game and hope to God he doesn't snowball too quickly so your counters come online in time, mm-hmm. or you draft the split push game and to avoid him and stall out the game.
Now, the Slaughter ban, it feels like Huskar, what you need to deal with him is physical damage. Of course, he has that that passive, that Berserker's Blood, which means that he's going to take very little magic damage as he gets low, and especially, depends where they put the Huskar, but if he's in mid, if he's safe lane, he can probably get reliable levels in the safe lane still, as long as the supports wander off and do jungle things, like stacking or ganking. But You now need a lot of physical. Dazzle's a good start with that weave, but it feels like needing another right clicker, and Alk wasn't what I was expecting when I said that. He has minus armor on the acid spray, and he certainly auto-attacks really fast with Chemical Rage, but he hits like a kitten. He just hits you a lot. He's like a kitten machine gun.
Actually really had to toggle against the as well, though, so I think Elk's fine here. It synergizes what they wanted to do before banning the AA. They're obviously thinking they wanted the Elk. Realizing that banning the AA unfortunately let Leviathan get the Huskar, but still deeming the Elk worth it. Probably going to put them in a position where they want to dodge the early game fights for as long as possible. Mm-hmm. The farm up on the heroes that matter. Play the more turtle based game, or at least trade farm.
Yeah, and while it's probably going to be the Alchemist that is popular right now, that we call it Poor Man's Naga Siren. At the same time, if he decides to go the, what I like to think of as Welfare Alchemist, where he gives everybody else handouts, he certainly already has two heroes that have great Aghanim Scepter upgrades. But Leviathan, going for the Lich, going to make sure their Huskar doesn't have to worry about that physical damage. Radiant
team ban. The hero that they want to deal with the Huskar with. It's a really good against Ember. Good if you go for the Yules, but if you go for Yellow Blade or you just catch him out, fights, they have to play really carefully around this Lina.
10 seconds yep. remaining. Yeah, that pure damage ultimate, well, when she gets it up to that, and as we've talked about, this could be mid, it could be support, she can get the Ags really early, and so it's something where you can't deal with that as Huskar, so.
Really hard to deal with. Like, you have to play the hero a different way. It's doable, though. Plenty of players deal with it.
Yeah.
AA is like the only hero you can't deal with. You're so far ahead, it really doesn't matter.
Yeah. And this is Leviathan's second game of picking Huskar in 6.85. And Huskar versus Alchemist, the current matchup is 22-15, as in Huskar has won 22 times against the 15 wins of Alchemist. So maybe Leviathan gonna have a bit of the edge here, although I have to say, I like, if this Lina is core, I like her as well, because she's gonna have that Fiery Soul, which will buff up her auto attacks, and she will be able to deal out some good physical damage to Huskar as well.
Lina's one of those heroes that you just don't like playing against as her. She has the stun to enable you to be life leeching, not armlet toggling, lets you focus on the auto attack this day. She doesn't need to build right click items, fire soul scale so well. I'm curious what they'll get now. I'm expecting an offlane here. Unless they want to run like the Huskar Lich as an offlane, which is doable, but I doubt you'd look for it.
And this is a hero we haven't seen as... I mean, he has been getting a bit more action. It does... I do like it a lot, the Magnus. I'm a bit surprised. I feel like Huskar maybe doesn't synergize with it as well, but other than that, the Ember Spirit does great, and so does... it works with the Lich, it works with the Winter's Curse, it works with Ember Spirit once he gets up his Battle Fury, so should be nice action there. 10 seconds
remaining. Presuming this will mean they Magnus mid, they do a dual offlane, and they put the one Ember bottom. They could swap those lanes up, but I expect it to be kind of 2-1. The Mag just gets on the offlane here, I'm really not a fan of it.
Yeah. So, either way, Cloud9, they now have an opportunity to pick something to deal with this. I don't know if this Lina is core, but I feel like a Rubick could be nice here for Cloud9. It can certainly help if the Magnus blinks in, if you can get off that instant Curse Point telekinesis and so on. And also, there's a plethora of nice things. Everything Wyvern has is great to steal. Lich has got some good business too. And certainly, if you can get that RP and so on, it should help out. But
good. Probably the best hero to deal with Mag as a support. But they're opting to run the Lina as a support instead. Which I think makes sense. No, it's an Elk support. That's...
something we haven't seen in ages. I am really interested to see exactly how this works out. I think he's going to be feeding people Aghanims. And I am excited.
I think he can do that as a support.
No, I think he can. I think I don't want to be wrong. Okay, you're probably right. He probably has to go like a much less greedy build, but I'm still excited for it. Either way, we're going to be getting into this game, folks. Let me turn us off of Prison Dota because we are still on Prison Dota. Let me get us out of that.
Freedom.
Yeah, freedom. And hopefully we don't having still mic issues. I know we're getting a little bit of cutting in and out. I don't know whether it's me, you, the team speak, or whatever, but we might have to switch over to Skype. We'll see. If it gets really bad, I'll Skype call you, and we'll do our casting through that. And if it's still really bad, I will just mic you.
I think mic was just a bit too far away, so I moved it close now.
Excellent. Excellent. Yeah, you were just dropping a word every now and again, so you'd be like, Lina's really great because... and then it would drop, and I'm just like, well, shit. That was the whole point of it. They're joking because Mason paused for them. That's cute. Either way, let's introduce the teams because we do have very little early team fight potential with a Huskar maybe, but I don't think Cloud9 is going to be looking for any of that action. On Leviathan, we've got Francis on that Ember Spirit. We've got Magnus being played up by Jenkins, so he's going to be running that offlane one. We got a little cute Bounty Hunter courier with he's a red eye there. He should probably get that looked at by a doctor. We've got Newsham on that Winter Wyvern. It is Newsham, not Newsham, as I initially thought. Always think that's pretty funny. Lich being played by Flying Zebra, and finally Shibby on that Huskar, who's headed out to bottom.
Over on Cloud9, we have 1437, aka Teban, on his Alchemist, MSS on the Darkseer, Zu on the Lina, Guy Mason, who paused for the enemy team, the Gyrocopter, and SVG on the Dazzle.
Yeah, and that actually is a really nice Lina cosmetic, that dress. It's got, like, purple stuff flying off of it. Like, this shit you can't do in real life. Oh. Yeah. Clothing.
Pretty sure the game we watched the other day, someone commented that it's a nice dress, and it was that exact dress, so, you know.
They were discussing, I think it was against Leviathan as well. I think it was Complexity versus Leviathan. They had a pause.
It was, actually.
They discussed how beautiful the dress is, how they would love to take Lina and that dress out on a date. You know, very important Dota-related things were discussed. So, we're probably going to have the normal rune split up. What has this out gone first? He's actually already skilled the Acid Spray, so not... I was thinking maybe he would still go the Grievous Greed build, try to get an early bottle, give it just over to his mid for free. I've seen that play before, but instead we're going to have a little bit of Acid Spray. There's Optic Burn coming out on MSS. Now they're putting it onto 1437. The Light Strike Array doesn't quite manage to do as much as maybe they wanted in the Burning Spear Shibby. He's going to go down here, but can he bring anybody with him? No, it looks like he's going to be the first blood. Burning Spears aren't going to take him out either. Oh, he doesn't even need to eat
really
trees.
Well,
yeah.
Oh my god, he missed.
Oh no. Yeah. And Jenkins is stock up on... the high ground with a ward on top of him. They're just going to auto-attack him down. Oh yes, yeah, second
blood.
Yes, you're
in 5, but he can go this way and he'll be fine.
This is so sad.
I like the fact these teams talk about it, but...
Yeah.
Fine, just buying some time, you know. Next level bait, actually, because he has experience for these creeps on the drive-by. They can't zone him out. Mason missed like one or two creeps. I think that's worth it, actually.
I don't think it was meant to be worth it, but yes, fortunately working out really well for our...
Level NA Dota place.
Yeah, let's just leave it at that. Either way, we have a weird dual lane down bottom. I have never seen one of these before. Our wonderful Vengeance on Stats can give us an update if this is actually something I've just never seen and super common. But we have our support alchemist, Chillaxin, with MSS on that offlane Deoxia. I mean, it's a hell lane. But
they're actually going to be able to go for it. Never mind.
Yeah, Jenkins actually pushes one of them backwards. Going to take a few auto attacks, but that Gyro, it was bad positioning. It seemed like Gyro was off in the creep wave a bit. That flak rocket barrage, not hitting the right hero.
He was trying to tank the Skewer, so he took the Gyro with him and could finish him off with a rocket barrage, but had to do. He managed to get away there. I really like what Cloud9 are doing bottom, because I realize the lane from Leviathan isn't particularly strong at the early level, so bringing the heroes down here to pressure as much as possible. Fortunately, the Huskar's not getting pressured too much at all. He's actually doing fine on last hits. He's hot at the moment.
Arms for the dead.
And apparently these lanes not super common, so we'll see if we can add some more to the stats bucket of roaming Alk. And Alk picks up an illusion. He has got a point in Grievous Greed now. So I'm really excited to see him stuffing Aghanims down those other heroes' throats. Everybody would love an Aghanims in this game. This is also a dual mid lane. I feel like this is fantastic. Yes, Ritsu is getting some farm here. By the way, this is Ritsu up on the Lina, if you're late to the show. Just rocking no name, because that's what he does. But you can tell it's... Oh, that's not the view I wanted for telling it's Ritsu. You can tell it's Ritsu because whatever anime this is in reference to is rocking. I really like this mid lane, though. It's getting Ember way more farm than he would have alone.
Yeah, it's best to use as a lich here because the mag's getting levels top when they realize the Alk's bottom. They can't completely zone him out. He's not going to have a good time getting last hits. He hasn't gotten any yet. He's getting his levels, so it's the most relevant part of doing this.
Yeah, and wow, yeah, that's a crap ton of Alk mid, and I think most of that popping out of the mages that just happened, so that's what happens when you get a million games of Dota in a short time, although I don't even know if we've had a million games of Dota. We probably have had a million games of professional Dota. I'm not sure. A million's a big number. Let's stop talking about numbers and take a look at mid.
If you count Dota 1, you probably have.
Mm. Yeah.
How about 2, though?
Lich is trying to get some stacks up. Of course, Ember is a hero who can deal with that, although he is having a rough time with Lich gone in middle. He's still got really good form, all things considered. I mean, yeah, he had a Lich, but Ember's a hero that loses this mid matchup. That's how you play it. You lose your mid, and actually, Jenkins feeling very unsafe on that top lane, eats his mango. But you lose mid, and you're just there for the experience. So, nice that he gets something, although Ritsu has his own just one stack? Yeah, just one stack to catch back up.
Over here as well, but that's probably for the Gyro. Mm-hmm. When he gets his cooldown, he can easily take that off.
Yep, and now Lich steals the Bounty Rune from Alchemist, who's very sad about that.
Yeah,
I think
now
it's...
So your plan is foiled now.
100%! One Bounty Rune gone! You can never feed Naganims again, yeah.
I mean, that's works. 2 Bounty Runes he didn't get, because
yeah,
one spawned on the other side of the map and one got stolen.
That's a fourth of an Aghanims right there. So, Nushim taking heaps of damage there, but they're still letting Huskar free farm, and I have mixed feelings about Huskar. This wasn't a tri-lane until right now, so it's gonna be fine. Actually, we have maybe a bit of an engagement. Let's see if Huskar can do anything, but he's not getting in range of the Burning Spears. Finally, though, nice Splinter Blast as well, and that's gonna be a dead 1-4-3-7 on that Alk. Ion Shell being a bit of a pain, but Nushim tanks it for Shibby. I was gonna say I'm not a fan of Huskar in tri-lanes because I feel like he's a hero who can fight very early on, especially if he gets those mad levels. Once he has 6, you just jump at people and dunk them. No, it's a type of dunk. So a nice kill there for the Huskar, but even early on with Burning Spears, he outputs so much damage.
This hero is just so annoying to play against. Even with the dual lane that they're doing to try and put pressure on him, he's still CSing all right. His popped off a bit now.
Yeah, and again, Jenkins out of position, and this time it results in a kill. Just a little bit too far out, looking like his skewer, maybe he just didn't have the mana for it, or his positioning was poor, you know? Might have been one of those places where if you skewer, you had to take Gyrocopter with you, which isn't what you want, so...
I think he's been spamming out the lane a bit as well, so maybe he just got caught without mana or on actually watching the lanes.
Yeah. Taking a lot of damage again. Huskar with them, and I actually feel like if Shibby doesn't think they can secure the kill, it's the right decision to keep farming the lane, because the sooner you get up that omelet, if you can get up the omelet before Alk is relevant, before you're too worried about the Lina's spam and everything, you're gonna have a good game.
Yeah, it's the most important thing this hero gets is like a good 3-4 minute start. But sorry, not 3-4, like first 10 minutes is really important. If you can get Tred's omelet, then basically the hardest hero to deal with at that period.
Yeah.
Snowball is advantage a lot. He has a pretty decent team as well at helping him out. The Lich is pretty good at fighting early. The Ember can be really good at fighting early when he's not the only carry that has to farm. Unfortunately, Mag's not the best hero, but once he gets his RP, he's quite happy to just use it on a support. Hello.
Wow, I can't believe Huskar tri-lanes have that high of a win rate. Well, color me wrong. That's what it is. So, Huskar has now transitioned to top, though. I'm not sure if that was just so they want him to maybe do some aggression onto Gyrocopter. Of course, with that Berserker's Blood, he can take a bit more of what Gyro's dishing out. He's still a bit squishy for it, but he's certainly one of the heroes that can handle it better. And this lane, if someone's out of position and gets skewered, Huskar's just going to kill them, dunk or no dunk.
I actually think it was just a response to the rotation Cloud9 were doing, because they were creep skipping bottom and they moved the Gyro down here to be able to push the tower, and Huskar just realizing he doesn't want any of that, he wants a contested farm, so he moves top. He's gonna push the tower in turn, he's gonna finish his armlet in the next 1 minute or two.
Yeah, and I'm really impressed. This Ember Spirit, who's maybe thinking of a little wraparound, no, he's just gonna say hello to 1437 on that Alk. This Ember Spirit is farming up a storm, all things considered. Gyro does have better farm, but Ember Spirit's doing quite okay, and he gets a ward to boot. How tasty. So I don't think this gank is gonna go well. They might be able to kill off SVG Savage up here, but I think they're just gonna push the tower a little bit. They've already lost their bottom in exchange for it, though, so Cloud9, that helps out all of their heroes, and oh, deny it. Oh, yeah, SVG denies the catapult. That's always frustrating for you if you're Shibby here.
So looking to get the Sol Ring out. Assuming he's gonna get his boots first, but look, place the ward right now. Quite sure exactly where he wants position, just wandering around.
Okay, if you're Leviathan, is it time to start smoking up? I just feel like you have, unlike C9's early aggression, actually speaking of this, Laguna Blade, it's completely eaten by the Flame God. I don't think Wicked can, I don't think Francis can fight this, but has an invis and is just following Ritsu around. Lightstrike Array gonna completely miss, uses the Searing Chains and Remnants all over his face. Goodbye, Ritsu. That was amazing. Popping the Flame God when Francis did. Fast fingers, slow fingers, I don't know, he probably was spamming it out of the Light Strike Array, but he got it off and ate the entirety of the Laguna Blade. So, well played, Francis. I was going to say, I feel like if you're Leviathan, you have a much early ganking lineup potential. Even if you have to use that Winter's Curse early on to secure kills, I think it's worth it smoking up, getting your Huskar some of those dunks, and just bringing hell to C9, although they're going to give Jenkins a bit of a bump. I'm a little bit surprised Jenkins didn't try to bait them onto more there.
Yeah, with the Huskar Armlet, they can be really aggressive right now. However, he still needs to be slightly careful. The Alk's in the area, it's really hard to Armlet toggle an Acid Spray. And they have the Grave to be able to keep heroes up, so... If he doesn't feed away much right now, I think it's really good. He should just focus on farming, get more levels, because he's still only level 6. And part of the hero, as you said earlier.
Yeah.
Not having the magic reduction at this point in the game's understandable, but he needs to have it soon.
It can really mean that he can man fight Gyrocopter. It's just one of those matchups similar to the Slark versus Gyrocopter, where just because of your innate spells, you really win that matchup. And if you can make sure you have maxed out Berserker's Blood by the time you want to be dunking him, you're gonna do well. So either way, we're taking a look-sees at bottoms where Wyvern is desperately trying to get her level 6. I don't think she's in any danger. Yeah, maybe MSS can run her down a little bit. She has Cold Embrace, though, and she should be fine. So just going to get this level 6. Now here comes Jenkins. He, of course, probably working towards a Blink Dagger on that Magnus.
She's dropping a stun top.
Oh, yeah, let's see what they can do here. But Shibby, you can see he's taking no damage. He goes for the dunk. He'll get the return kill. I think he has it. Winter's Curse just to make sure. But with that Shallow Grave, they might not get anything. And now they pop the Chemical Rage. They're going to kill off SVG on the back lines. And now Mason, he's looking to be in a pot of trouble. But there's no more Flame Guard up for Francis. He needs to get the hell out of there. He's taking a bit of damage. The stun comes out onto Flying Zebra. And Laguna Blade going to finish that Lich off. Wow,
really
rotations
from C9.
Yeah. And really nice use of the Chemical Rage of everything else to make sure to keep up Mr. Alchemist. Even though he's just a support Alchemist, still good to not let Huskar get anything in return. But still, we saw 2 points of Berserker's Blood keeping him alive for so long. Are we going to see another dunk? We do. There is the stun follow-up. He needs like one more charge. No, it's not going to be enough. She's not going to burn down to it. Oh, it's close. It is. Oh, the heal comes out of Dazzle. Shadow Ward coming out. There's going to be a dunk, though. He's going for it. He just needs to hit over. He gets the kill. I don't think that was worth it, though. I don't think giving up your life for the Lina, and instead, let's see if they can do anything to- They actually pop the ult, but Jenkins realizing he's taking way too much damage, but here comes the Remnants. Where is the Searing Chains? He has to kill these two creeps. He gets the lucky Searing Chains, but now he doesn't have enough damage. They do. They just managed to get it. Did they use- No, he doesn't have Empower yet, so they just managed to, between the two of them, get the damage, and that's going to even things up here. Looking at the net worth graph, it's a little bit in favor of Cloud9, but I imagine after all of those engagements, we're pretty damn near even.
Yeah, and with the Huskar right now, he's not farming very well. He just picked treads. I'm not sure what the average timings are, but I feel like he's an item behind where he wants. He should be where the Ember is right now, as opposed to being fourth, which is equal to the Lina, I feel like.
A lot of Huskar's... Well, I think a lot of the Huskar stats we have, at least for the games I've casted, I see it a lot in the Americas Dota, and players sometimes forgo shoes, so it's the items are... timings are really skewed, because like they will even not get brown boots in a lot of the South American Dota games I cast, so hard for me to give you a number on those timings. Of course Vengeance might be able to, yeah, average about 13 minutes, so he's doing okay. He's got treads, he's got omelets. Oh, we got an air award. I haven't seen one of these in a while. Not important.
Yeah, there's been a few this game.
Yeah, somebody has a cosmetic. We've got Savage wrapping around. Oh, he wants to put down a ward, but it's right on top of a sentry. Of course, they're not going to notice this until they get in vision, since sentries don't give you vision, but somebody's going to walk by there at some point and see it and be like, delicious 50 gold. Oh yeah, the creeps will kill it. Good old creeps. So, nice of them.
I've actually been preemptively dewarding Sion at least twice this game. They did it once mid lane, which is a bit more common, but predicting this ward's really away from them.
Yeah.
Alf also just picks up Medallion, so Roche is becoming a possibility. Mason's getting himself an Ancient Stacker. It's currently triple.
Both teams have good Roshan lineups. It's something Huskar can actually solo once he picks up some lifesteal. Another item I'm surprised he hasn't gone. He favored the treads over it instead. Of course, you can lifesteal now with Huskar pretty easily, and it helps you a lot. You attack Falster with that Berserker's Blood, you lose life using your Burning Spears. It's all good.
Expect him to get it next, for sure.
Yeah, definitely the next item. We have a nice Searing Chains. I don't know if they'll be able to do anything. They get him super low, and they pop the Winter's Curse. Will this be a suicide? Not enough. I was maybe hopeful there, but no, looks like Ritsu has a haste. He doesn't hit the Life Striker. He dodges it with the Searing Chains, and Remnant's over. Gonna be just fine on Francis. Really nice Ember Spirit play coming out. Last time it was on Shibby, but Francis showing that he can play it just as well. And a nice little Splinter Blast coming out of Wyvern. I have to say, giving the Wyvern some space on bottom to get levels, I think is one of the best things, because that Splinter Blast, it is a 7-second cooldown, it is a massive damage early game, hugely spammable spell. Really nice to make sure Wyvern not only gets that Winter's Curse, but also just picking up more items, a little bit of farm, having arcanes, and Splinter Blasting all over the place.
Yeah, I feel like this is the way you want to play the hero. You want to prioritize at least some kind of early game.
Oh, dodges the Light Strike Array coming out, but Shibby, I think, is still going to go down, and yeah, again, another kill. Not walking out so much, but Ritsu might fall here. Taking some burning, no, it's not enough, has the bottle charges, so a nice Splinter Blast attempt coming out of Nushum, but not enough.
And that's exactly why. That did so much damage, and heroes on Cloud9, they aren't that tanky. They have the Dazzle to top them off a bit, but tank one or two Splinter Blasts on top of everything else coming out from Leviathan, you're not going to be in fighting shape. And also the ultimate is really important in this game, to be able to lock down the Elk if he's stunning, because they don't have too much. Actually, that's their only hard lockdown, minus RP. On top of that, when Jarrah gets BKB, he's going to want to have the levels in first. go to lock him down?
Yeah, it feels like both teams actually a bit light on the lockdown. We've got Rocket, Light Strike Array, and Alk Stun. I guess Poison Touch also maxed has a, you know, a big stun, but it's Poison Touch. We don't talk about it, even though it's skilled. And then we have RP, Searing Chains, Wyvern's Winter's Curse, Mini Stun on Frost Chain Frost. Yeah. So we're not exactly huge in the big, reliable lockdown, and I wonder if that means that eventually these teams, maybe sooner rather than later, are going to be wanting sheep sticks. But either way, this Lich is in no man's land. He's going to walk it off. They're going to see that ward. Yeah, I don't know if they realized he dropped it. They should be able to check the inventories, but sometimes hectic when you're trying to ward yourself on Savage.
Huskar goes down again in top lane.
Really surprised.
I'm not sure what he's doing.
Yeah, it feels like he keeps going up to that top lane and it's not working out.
He should know right now that he's way behind where he needs to be. He just needs to go bottom, secure his farm, and get to the point where he's actually relevant in the game. Because right now, he's counted out really well just by this Alk and the Lina on their own.
It also...
So if Doro gets damaged, it's even harder for him.
Yeah, it feels like he went the helm. I think if he had gone the lifesteal, we're going to have an engagement out of the smoke. They do have the Winter's Curse that they can cast on someone, but Alk is going to stun if you're not careful. He gets it off, but he's in a bit of danger himself. Where is the RP? There it is. But oh, the skewer, we need the follow-up. There's going to be a nice Winter's Curse. They're doing lots of damage with the Lich ulti being wasted on the 70% damage reduction. Jenkins does go down, but here comes the dunk. Shibby, he is standing in that minus armor though, and there is a wall. Super late, no vacuum follow-up. Shibby, he needs to walk out of it. He doesn't. He pops, gives 9 extra gold. It turns out it's a favorable team fight for Leviathan, but it is messy, and I think a lot of that being Magnus RP'd, and then you can see he wasn't sure whether he wanted to force both of those heroes back, maybe trying to just find one.
I think he tried to turn in the RP so he could get the skewer off easier, but he just didn't get it in time, so
okay.
Realizing they're actually diving.
Holy cow, Francis, yeah, he's going in super deep. He's gonna have that Flame Guard purged off. Can the Light Strike Array hit? No, it's not gonna hit there. Takes too much to turn around there and everything. At the same time, he does manage to dodge the vacuum with that Sleight of Fist, but now he's in no man's land, dodges the Dragon Slave as well, and picks up more than enough to pop in his bottle. He's gonna be fine. He doesn't actually have, oh goodness, he's thinking about re-engaging.
Yeah, that was really lucky timing for the Yules being delivered on the Lina. Otherwise, yeah, she was dead there.
Yeah, knocking off that Flame Guard certainly helpful. They missed the skewer backwards for Jenkins and not going to secure the out kill there. But all in all... No, not at all. All in all, this Ember Spirit's farming really well for this game. He's at 450, which is, you know, he's not a hero who traditionally wins his mid-matchup, so he's doing pretty well. And he will be getting, he also went the drums, so it puts back his Battle Fury, but I still think he can get a 25-minute one, just with how this game has been going, assuming he doesn't get picked off or ganked.
Yeah, having the Ember as well means he can farm a lot easier, and he doesn't necessarily need the Battle Fury to take it helps a lot.
Yeah, they do have a nice... They actually got really nice Searing Chains there, but Ember Spirit gonna realize there are too many of them and he doesn't actually want to fight there. But the blink up! They want to go on Lina, the immediate Yules, that's what we were talking about. It is a zero cost point and goodbye, Jenkins. He
is
did not want to be there.
Jaro? He's gonna be up to get Wyvern here, I think?
Yeah, he's looking, but Wyvern uses that Arctic Bone and just flip-flaps away. So not gonna find the kill, although maybe Mason, he is moving like a fast race car. He must have, yeah, he is also fast right now with the phase boots, with a surge.
He's not a race car, he's a race helicopter, please.
It's a car. It's got wheels. No, I don't know what that is. Either way, Ember Spirit goes down. Completely missed that as we're talking about cars. He was in way too deep, and there's going to be a self-stun, but they can't defend this tower, and this is going down for Leviathan. They had a couple good team fights, but now a really bad engagement there, losing a number of core heroes and their Wyvern, so... At least, you know, saving grace, not exactly how they wanted it, but now Shibby's getting some space on the Huskar.
Yeah, but... When you're behind at this point with a Huskar, you kind of feel like the reason you drafted that hero is just come null and void.
Yeah,
so
he
right
doesn't...
Now, they're on the Ember train.
He doesn't exactly farm from behind. He wanted those levels. He wants to kill heroes. You don't exactly farm well in the jungle either. So, Huskar not doing so great, really. Having a rough game. How do you get back into this? I feel like Leviathan, they're not super far behind. We can see about 5,000 gold, maybe 3,000 experience when this settles down. It's not awful, but it is, you need to win a few team fights to get back into it. Two team fights should put you back in if you have good ones. I think maybe smoke ganks, you certainly could just blow your big Winter's Curse to lock someone down and kill them, or do you want to just sit back and farm on the Ember Spirit?
really want to be applying pressure. I think it's mostly reading what Cloud Nine want to do and then you counteracting it at the right times. Because Nine go for Rosh at some point, you could definitely fight there. Same for the Ancient Stacks, you could fight there. But ideally, you'd want to be able to push like, on bottom or tier 1. That's quite a bit easier, but I don't think Cloud Nine let you gonna do that yet. So, said, get the Ember's items up. Hopefully the Husker is able to pick up like another item. Maybe he can into Roche while the other four are doing the map. I don't think that's going to happen though. Cloud9 should be on top of that. And they also have the Dominator from Mason, so he can constantly be sending his creep in to check Roche. The Husker off the map.
Yeah, it also feels like Jenkins got the blink pretty early on. It feels like he's had the blink for a while and he hasn't gotten another item, nor does he have a lot of gold saved up. Do you just finish off your boots? Like what?
Yeah, you need
what...
Arcanes.
Okay. Arcanes, did you go straight? I don't know. I feel like there are a couple different builds. He might want a BKB here just so that he doesn't immediately get yulzed or stunned up, you know, when he tries to blink in RP. But he could also...
Glimmer or Force, I think.
Yeah.
All he can do this game is empower people and initiate, slash counter-initiate. Mm-hmm. Force helps so much.
Yep.
As you've seen, like, Bryce do it several times with Mag, he's really comfortable with just Blink Arcane's Force. He can make a lot of plays happen on that hero. Those items, so if Jenkins can do the same thing, I expect him to go for those items. BKB's a bit greedy, I think. I don't think he's going to be able to get that farm. Glimmer Cape's another item.
Glimmer Cape pretty is pretty nice here. Yeah, Gyrocopter early game, he's all magical damage. Lina as well, while she will get up an Aghanim's making her ult pure damage, the rest of her spell kit, the spammable part, is all magical. And they're going to run into two. I think this teamfight's favorable. Oh gosh, Nusham going down. He pops the Arctic Bone, but there's an RP. Can Nusham do any sort of follow-up before he goes down? There is the Wyvern ult. He's going to actually try to heal himself up inside of this. Magnus has been picked off, but here comes Mr. Huska. I don't think he's going to do anything here. He is surrounded. Where is his backup? There's a beautiful Lich ulti going around now. It might be able to kill off Lina. It gets Lina. It's still bouncing. There's a courier as well. Huskar's killed off Dazzle. And I think this team fight is going as well as they could hope for on Leviathan. Maybe they can pick up the Gyrocopter on the back lines. Here comes Lich with the Frostblast. They get it with the Searing Chains. They're now trying to follow up on MSS. And this Alk, he's caught in no man's land. He doesn't have the Chemical Rage for a while. They'll have to walk through the wall, but you'll do it to catch out Mr. Alchemist, shutting him down when he is getting super fat. He's going to have the stun. He's going to throw up, but Sleight of Fisting gets the kill. Wicked cosplay. A bloody Francis with a fake name using somebody else's account is gonna get the kill.
Guessing it's his own account.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Wicked Cosplay's account. The girl who cosplays named Wicked.
Just shout her out and name after her because he likes her. I don't know.
Oh, I think it's actually a different account. I've heard he uses multiple accounts, but yeah, you're right. I guess it could be just him repping the tag. I assumed he just, like, you know...
I wouldn't give someone my account for them to play on. They're probably just gonna... Right?
I have no idea, you're right. I guess I have definitely, when I was younger and didn't have money for games before I had a job, shared Steam accounts to make sure we could all play them. So.
Yeah, but I don't think pro players are going to have to do it at all.
I don't know. His manager, I quote, said on Leviathan, it was like, he likes to use Smurf or fake other people's accounts for professional matches, so I just assumed he was like, hey, can I use your account, please? Please, sir? I am your brother. Either way, not important. Really good team fight for Leviathan, and if they can take a few more like that, they can get themselves back into this game. Lich is now rocking the medallion, which is going to help them a lot. Alk is working on a Glimmer Cape. I wonder when... I do still hold out hope for the Aghanim's feeding, and I wonder when that's going to happen. Wyvern has ult up here. This is a really ambitious Roshan. Yeah, you've got a crap ton of minus armor, but Leviathan not going for it.
I think they're just too scared to go in right now, because MSS is positioning really well. If he sees heroes here, he's just going to back them away. Yeah. Might lose his own life, but securing the Rosh is really important here.
I'm pretty surprised because I feel like both teams, while they both have good Roshan pit fight, I do feel like it's a game where the better... Whoever's in the pit suffers, because whoever's in the pit is going to be the one taking that gyro cooldown, the acid spray, the vacuum wall combo, you know, maybe a vacuum to the high ground. Whoever's in the pit is taking the RP, the Winter's Curse, and actually, going to see what he can do. He gets the Searing Chains, has the Yules up to get rid of that Flame Guard, but taking so much damage from the creeps. Laguna Blade, Light Strikery, but there is the combo that they needed. An RP coming out. Can they get the Alk as well? They do. They just need to get out of that acid spray, and they're going to be fine. Really well done from both of them. Magnus, maybe not wanting to be right here, but there's going to be another Searing Chains, and do they have the damage. Flame God back up in 5. MSS, I don't think you want to be here. He does so much damage with just the sleight of fist here. MSS is going down. One more auto attack. Come on, get this guy. Jenkins might die to the creeps in the wall. There's going to be a cooldown. They're getting away. Can his illusions finish off Jenkins? He blinks away in time. What a nice team fight just coming out from Leviathan. Really taking advantage, I think, a good bait-ish there by Francis. Now actually thinking of killing off Dazzle in the mid, but Rocket's gonna hit and I don't... Oh, he's actually gonna turn around and kill the Dazzle here, I think. Sleight of Fist gets him! What was Dazzle thinking?
Desperation, I guess? I'm gonna salvage the fight. I'm gonna kill the Emperor and then those two illusions. Technically, yeah, that's just light, but...
Just with this, Cloud9 getting themselves back into it. We're at zero net worth. Sorry, Leviathan getting themselves back into it. We're at zero net worth, and we're at an experience advantage for Leviathan.
Cloud9 have just been... Brosh was really smart. They did the right thing, but then just getting too greedy was splitting the heroes up after... Recognize they don't want to fight. Leviathan, this is, don't want to fight 5-on-5 in the pit. So then as soon as Cloud9 split up, they're more than happy to just blow the RP up here. Really smart Mag being there to pick up his team and let these plays actually benefit them.
Yeah, so really well done, and making space, maybe not enough, but maybe going to be enough space for Shibby to get back into this game. Now, I am always concerned. It feels like Huska, as you said, he's a hero that relies on snowballing. He's not so great with the being behind picking up items. He could maybe get himself a Heaven's Halberd here, but Gyro mostly magical damage, Lina mostly magical damage. What are you building?
Me?
Yeah, he's got a BKB, but like, you just think you go for the Satanic? It means you're not outputting a heap of damage. Yeah, Huskar is a damage over time hero, and he is someone where this is one of the downsides of Huskar. If you want to ensure that you're going to kill someone, you have to keep hitting them after they would have long been dead to flaming spears if you just wandered off, which is a bit of a downside because it does mean that you have to either commit to killing off someone like the Lina, or she does pump out her own damage. At the same time, you can be a real pain in those team fights, and your Life Break, it does purge some stuff as you use it, so I'm wondering if he can maybe not have to deal with a few things here. Using that Life Break wisely.
Not too much this game, though. I don't think you can push Dazzle ult, right?
I don't think Dazzle ult, but maybe the Poison Touch slow, I think. Yeah, I am slowly
that's
working...
That's so negligible.
Hey, what if that's what kills you? Omelette toggle, and you're like, shit. Oh, goodness, I missed the mid-kill because I'm taking a look down at bottom. They want to do something here. Can Wyvern do any sort of follow-up? But no. And yeah, it looks like Lina, Ritsu, just out of position. I missed that mid-kill since I was looking at the bottom, thinking we were going to get action.
Just RP into Ember coming.
Oh, they committed the RP. I think all of the lineup of Cloud9 needs... Yeah, definitely worth it for the mid-core. All of the lineup of Cloud9 needs to back out here, especially with Chemical Rage coming off cooldown. 1-4-3-7. Can't really tank up on that. And this is something where the support Alchemist, he's got a Shadow Blade, actually, I think, for locking down Ember Spirit. Wants to be able to pop that stun on the Ember Spirit. Oh, Wyvern. An Arctic Burn away. I think...
He's got the Blink as well, so he's farming pretty well.
Yeah, and a gem. This Wyvern is big,
his
despite
gem?
Having...
Yeah. The Lich got it for him.
Yeah, Lich bought it for him, but, you know, it happens.
Work.
Which a Lich will do. Lich with zero own charges. It's how it should be. You should keep it at zero. You should use them liberally, because you get two when it's at zero. So, Alka was going to say, I think he... Actually, I wanted to check something. I think it's really hard to... play this Alk as support now, just because he's always been hard to... He's one of those heroes where they expect you to do... Because you farm so fast, you don't have good stat gain on the hero. So you're very squishy. And I don't know if this 4-second stun... Yes, that is a hell of a long time. I think the only stun that's longer is Max Strength Morphling stun is 4.25 seconds. I'm just talking stuns, not holds, folks. But... I don't know if that's worth
five
it.
5 seconds.
Yeah, but, oh yeah, that's another one that's really long. Again, not so super reliable. Alk's done reliable. Jenkins missing on that skewer again, but it does secure them the tower. And those, nice damage coming out. BKB has been forced out from Mason. If they can just back out gracefully for Leviathan, they can definitely win this team fight, wasting that big BKB self-stun onto 7472. And I think that was the 10-second BKB. Yeah, it was. Leviathan, great
they
job by really them
should
right
be really confident
there.
Pushing now. Still have RP, they still have Curse. Good to go here.
Yeah. Hopefully the Curse doesn't end up stacking with the Lich ulti again. Just That is where, when you use the Winter's Curse, whoever is attacking the cursed unit, you take 70% less damage. And this does mean that if you drop your Lich Ulti in the curse, while you are getting the bounces, they're really tickling. At the same time, it still might be nice to get it out there, because when the curse does end, only being 3.5 seconds at max level, it will still be all the heroes grouped up, taking a lot of Lich Ulti. But with that, Leviathan, easy tower for them.
Yeah, also MKB on the Ember as well now, so wanting to deal with the Solar Crest.
Pretty interesting there. I think this game he does feel like he has, because he's gotten form so fast, he does have more room to fight up in their faces, but I'm much more used to Ember Spirits just letting the cleave do the damage, not worrying as much about the evasion, since of course cleave ignores evasion.
Yeah, I'm not the big fan of it, but he's been playing really well this game and he's comfortable with what he's doing, so not wanting to deal with Solar Crest Mist was annoying, even though it got nerfed. The item can still fuck you over.
Yeah, it's definitely painful, especially if you're trying to run down that one lost hero and you can't get them. Either the Alk is getting away with Chemical Rage, making him really hard to kill because he's regenning so fast, and then also the Mist Chance, or he pops it on one of his allies and they just walk out of the team fight because you have no one else to cleave around on. And it's decent damage. It's not a bad damage item at all. I do expect a Chrysalis Daedalus rush next.
I'd agree with that. I don't think he's going to opt for anything.
Maybe a Lifestrike Array going to hit. They have the cooldown as well. He's able to force stuff out of it. It's really hard to hit that combo, and they vacuum back. It doesn't quite hit. Lich Ulti is bouncing around. Nushim maybe going to take a lot of damage to Laguna Blade. Somebody needs to pick up the gem. They're going for it, and now they have Lich Ulti still bouncing, for goodness sake. RP is up, but without the Wyvern and the gem, Huskar does manage to get it. So
I think this was really important as well right now. If Cloud9 pop the sword, they're going to feel a lot more confident.
Yeah. I think Magna should just really go regen. Yeah, he does end up going back to the fountain. I think there's no reason to stick around. You know they're probably not going to fight on the lineup of Cloud9 with that wall already being dropped.
And he did go for the 4-staff and the arcanes, like I said. Lina also picking up the eggs now, so she has a way of dealing with the Huskar.
Yep.
It's not that easy at the moment. They don't have the most physical damage. If he doesn't go into the fight really low HP because of armlet toggling or whatever, then he's not going to be in range for the Laguna for quite a while, especially with the BKB. So it's not easy to play for Cloud9 right now. Jaro just doesn't have the physical damage output yet to be able to force the car low enough.
So apparently Francis got himself a very early MKB on the Ember Spirit. Well done there. Either way, I think... wait a second. I don't know if you called this, but he's got an ultimate orb. Is this... So probably Lincoln's the Lincolns. Yeah. Oh, I would love it if it were the Scotty. I think Scotty is a very underrated item on Ember Spirit. It's an easy way to tank up, and it gives you a lot of utility. That AoE slow that you end up getting because of Sleight of Fist, I think, is super powerful. Especially here, Gyrocopter, he doesn't actually have long range except in Flat Cannon. A lot of the spells he wants to be up in close to you with Rocket Barrage and so on. And while Flat Cannons, it's only 6 shots at that 1,000 range. So, yeah. I like
actually,
it.
Actually, it's definitely going to be Scotty, just be playing with a mag. Need the damage right now. He already hits for 330-ish a hit. He just wants to tank up, so you can actually right-click in fights as well, as opposed to being a fight at this spot.
I feel like you've always got to go for the RNG, maybe just because I am a huge Ogre Magi fan, but yeah, don't listen to me, folks. Listen
like
to the...
big numbers.
I do like big numbers. Who doesn't?
Look at.
Yeah. Oh gosh, and as I'm saying that, I see Wicked's health falling. Didn't think he would actually go down because he has Remnants active, but they managed to get more than enough stun, and that's the Shadowblade doing some work. So they finally managed to kill off Francis there. He is the top net worth, so a huge big kill for them, especially since they were a little bit behind there. And yeah, now that this Alk is farming up a storm, I'm constantly trying to click around to see if anybody has been given an Aghanim's.
That's not gonna happen.
No, it's gonna happen, okay?
No! Not!
He's
got items himself this game.
I want to believe.
Silver Edge? Might also go for a Blink just for more initiation, but Silver Edge is a really good way of dealing with Huskar. No.
It is. It's certainly an item that
tanks
does.
Him up.
Tanks you up, gives you some more damage. Yeah. So it gives you some more damage for Mr. Alchemist, and it. Since he's a strength hero, but I don't know. I guess he will be able to get it off and use it on the Husker. They've been doing a really good job knowing that Shibby had a really hard early game grouping up around him, but this could be a smoke coming out, or it could just be them going into Roche. Yeah, it's a half smoke. Ritsu wasn't smoked up there. They're going in for the Roshan. They don't know about this. I'm a bit surprised that this ward. No, they do know about it. I think they have all the tools to go in. I know they don't have Ember Spirit, but you have to know that he can TP in, and I think you have to do something here if you're Leviathan, but they're just going to give up this Roshan. Here comes the Wyvern finally. Windows Cause, maybe she can steal it, but she is Yuled up. It doesn't look like she's getting it. There is an RP as well. The Roshan still isn't dead. Who's going to pick it up? Alk has managed to get it, and Nushum is down, has already dropped his ult. Here comes Shibby, just trying to pound away into them with the BKB. Vacuumed up to the wall for Flying Zephyr. He has no ult, but he can use the Frost Floss there, and now Shibby finally in a position to do work. This team fight's gone disastrous. Leviathan take it, even though they don't get the Aegis, and I think actually Flying Zephyr being put up here allowed him to Frost Floss onto the low ground, killing Lina. He wouldn't have been, I think the walk time around would have taken him a while if he had just been left over here instead of being vacuumed up. You know.
They still know the Alk's in the area, so he's going to lose the Aegis here.
Yeah, he does go down.
He should die a second time.
Yeah. He Shadowblade up? Yeah, he will die a second time. They can see you, mister, and you're going to go down. And as you said, with that Empower, this guy doesn't need crits. You're right. He's hitting like a truck.
Yeah, this combo is so strong when the Ember's this far ahead. Unfortunately, Cloud9 have just not been in a position where they've ever been able to take control of this game. Actually, due to the fact that Ember's playing really well.
Yeah. So, Francis doing... Yeah, he's doing much better. It is Francis on the Ember this time instead of Shibby. I don't think Shibby played terribly last game. I think it was just a much harder game. We talked about it. It felt like Cloud9 had the jump on the draft. But Francis doing good work here. He is 8-2 and with 10 assists to boot. So now they're going to be pushing onto this high ground. We have some buybacks coming out. Let me go make sure you can all see that. This is going to be one use, but they already got the tower and forcing a buyback, albeit on a support alchemist. You're still happy with that. It's going to put him further and further away from the AC that he's building, not the Silver's Edge.
He also, he needs to help his team out a bit more. Silver Edge is a much more selfish item.
Yeah.
BKB from Husker means it's not as relevant that you actually take his pass
away.
Yeah,
we've got a single man RP, but Mason, he is in the danger zone. Winter's Ghost keeping the backline busy. They do actually get off a nice vacuum wall, light striker ray combo, and they take out Lich, but now, when Shibby pounding into them, there's gonna be a stun. It's not gonna do enough. He's got Boning Spears coming out. The regen isn't enough for Alchemist. Gyrocopter goes down anyway. Searing Chains, everything. They're just all dying, and this is an easy Rax for... Oh, they called a GG. We're going to a game three.
And the casual courier in the middle lane at the end of the game.
Yeah. Go. But yeah, apparently the stats there earlier were cut off, so I will give you that in next game. We're having stats reborn is broken, so our wonderful stats man Vendance is trying to do the best he can with the fact that apparently you can't currently enter like multiple box stats. So he's doing really well with what he has. We'll give you some stats in next game, but I'm just gonna get us into game two right quick. Once again, I'm Llama Down Under. I've been joined by PQ and